we were like probably one of the first people who used quantum design in games, which is like a really exciting thing to think about. And just the idea of how novel it is to do something with quantum at a design school, I thought was pretty cool.
I'm someone who's really into emerging tech. Like I grew up in the Silicon Valley, so it's been like something that's surrounded my life. So it was really interesting to be able to work with quantum computers. It was something I didn't think like anybody outside of research was able to use for like the next 5 years at least.
I've always kind of jumped around different mediums, and like from painting to fashion to film, photography, but the idea of experimenting that's more technical or scientific in any way just kind of scared me because I haven't done it in so long. But once I got into it, like, yeah, I don't understand everything, but it's kind of, that's the beauty in it, is that there's so much space to explore.
I wanted to participate in the jam anyway, just like because I think it's interesting to work hands-on together with IBM, and I wanted to see maybe like a quantum computer in real life.
I'm also in the quantum computing class, and I'm personally always very interested in implementing technology in design and art and music.
Because we just felt like after coming back like in person after a long time, we just felt like we needed to like do some like team stuff together.
Like we're third year, so we spent our entire second year, or like the first year of our major, on Zoom. Like we've never met each other before.
So for a prototype, we collaborated with an artist and Jared Huffman. So he's based in Brooklyn and he has a studio. He's a lenticular artist, and we collaborated with him using like our quantum pictures, and we interlacing with the lenticular pieces, and then we make the effect more of like the quantum experience, so users can see it from like both angles.
So we've worked on a game called Q-Sweeper, which is a quantum version of the Minesweeper game. We improved upon the game by using concepts like entanglement and interference, and we changed up the mechanics a bit to suit the improved game.
So when you're looking outside the window, everything's stable to you and still, but just like quantum, they're not stable. It just sort of have this higher probability that it's there, but it's actually constantly changing and flipping its characteristics. And so it sort of represents that staleness and unstableness inside our life.
Okay, our project is called Quantum Tetris, and we try to explore how quantum computing and the true randomness of quantum computing could affect like a Tetris game. And on top of that, we also looked into the noise that quantum computers currently produce, which is like a thing that hopefully is not in quantum computers anymore in the future, and how this would affect like generating or disrupting a game and adding a new gameplay feature to it.
For me, it was more about like trying something new. I've been looking a lot at how fashion and technology kind of merge together for like immersive storytelling and whatnot. So I was interested in this new thing that I had nothing to know, like I knew nothing about, and so I just decided to kind of go with it.
Yeah, I guess the big challenge in this workshop was because it was like in a, such a compact time, and quantum computing topic is such a complex topic.
I actually think that doing it hands-on is not as crazy or difficult as you thought it might be. It's just like learning, I guess, learning Illustrator or Photoshop. It's like you have no idea what's going on in the first 3 weeks, but then you just get it. And I think just experimenting with projects, and then that will lead you to figure out the technical parts.
For me, it was a lot of acknowledging everybody, where everybody's abilities are. Like, if you know like coding computation more and you're doing that, that doesn't mean you are more essential or less essential to your project. It's just where the skills lie, because there's nobody in our team, I feel like if they weren't part of our team, we would have had the same project. It was something where like everybody had a component and it came together. And like at this point, I don't even know like who did what.
We should high five.
experimenting with new technology like quantum computing really made me realize that we need support for cross-disciplinary artists. And you know, I think a lot of times in the industry, the infrastructure is not set up so great for emerging students, designers, or artists to be able to combine things together while living. So we hope that that can be pushed forward.